So in general, the word patch will let us know that we are trying to add some additional data to the existing data. So if you have seen our previous tutorial update, that is put API request, we are trying to change the entire row which we have added previously. But with the help of patch API request, we are going to change only the necessary data and the rest of the data will remain the same. In this vlog, we will try to see the implementation of patch API call in Flutter application. So what is a patch API call and why do we make use of it? So now, if you have gone through our previous tutorials, we have seen get post update, that is put API request in Flutter application using DO library. And in this part of the tutorial, we would like to see the implementation of the patch API request. If you are new to this particular API request, I suggest you to watch this tutorial till the end. And now let's get started. To the backend developers, this might not be a new scenario, but to the frontend developers and who are especially beginners in application development, patch API request might sound a new scenario for you. But don't worry, by the end of this tutorial, you will be getting a very good knowledge on what is a patch API request, and also you will find it very interesting to use this particular API request rather than update or put API request, which we have seen in our previous tutorial. So now let's try to see what is a patch API request first, and for that I would like to make a get API call to show you the data which we are getting. So now let's start our simulator and try to run this particular code and try to observe the API call and the data which we are getting by making that particular API call. So in general, the word patch will let us know that we are trying to add some additional data to the existing data. So if you have seen our previous tutorial update, that is put API request, we are trying to change the entire row which we have added previously. But with the help of patch API request, we are going to change only the necessary data and the rest of the data will remain the same. Let's try to run this particular code here. And here we have got a get data button, and when we tap on this, you can clearly observe the output here. So this is the output which we have got by making use of a get API request. So very quickly, let's try to add a patch API request as well and try to observe its output. So now I'm going to create a variable response2 here, which will be again we are going to add await, so because this is an asynchronous method and network calls, we need to wait for some time to get the data. Here we have got the set of API requests like get, patch, put. So let's try to add patch here, and the very first thing is like we need to add the URL. So just copy this particular URL and we are going to use the same URL here. So let's add the URL as the first parameter. So let's try to add the URL as the first parameter. And I think we already know what is the second parameter which we are going to add here. Yes, it's data. And inside the data, we are going to send the required data which we want to patch here. So just I would like to pass name here and specify my name. And now let's try to run this particular code and observe the output once. And yes, we have forgot to add a print statement here. So let's try to add the print statement also. And now try to rerun the code here. And it's very quick. So let's tap on the get data button here, and you can see get data button is having both our get and patch API request implemented. So let's try to observe the response here. So here you can see we have got almost the same response, but here name is being appended to the previous response which we have got here. So this is our previous response which we got by making a get API request, and this is our current response here. So till here the response is same, but name and Abhi, this particular parameter name is being appended to our existing data. So to make it much easier for you to understand, I'm going to rename name to title here. So here you can observe title is, so this is our title here, and the same title we have got in patch even. So let's try to rename it to title and try to find the actual use of a patch API call. We have got our application restarted and tap on the get data button here, and now here you can see this is the title which we have got in get API request, and now this is the title which we have got in patch API request. So here it is very clear that our title is being replaced. Only our title is being replaced and the body is being continued with the same old data here. So body is same in both the API request, but only the title is patch. So here patch is like appending the data which we are passing here. So we have passed title here and the title is only appended to the existing data, and the rest of the API call remains the same. And basically where you use this particular patch API calls is like in generally in like profile screen in your application, where the user can change his details and the previous details should be existing and the only updated details should be added to your database replacing the old data. And here clearly understand, for example, user wants to update his mobile number, only the mobile number should be updated with a new mobile number rather than clearing up all the email address, other user details. Okay. And there is another way to update it, like making use of a put API request where you will be passing all the details again to the server. But making use of a patch API request is more beneficial for you because every time you need not rewrite everything in the database, just you can just replace the required fields, that's all. And it is very quick compared to the put API request as well. This type of patch API request is very much useful for you where you want to deal with a large amount of data in an API call, and you can just pass the required fields rather than passing all the fields. For example, in an API call here, you have got user ID, ID, title and body. To make an update call, that is put API request, you need to pass all these four parameters and their values to update any of the value in them. But here, by making use of the patch API request, you can clearly see what we have did. We just passed the title. So we have not passed user ID or ID or body here. So they are just the same which were existing previously. So this is it for the patch API request implementation. And I hope you understood this particular concept. So this is not any new concept. This is an old existing concept itself. But it's not majorly used by, but few of the beginners might not have known this particular thing and it might sound very new for them. The code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to this channel for more interesting content on Flutter.